is not an ideal place to have explosives, and that would require an evacuation around that house. So we are in for a day with a capture or without a capture of some continued tension and some drama.
CBS senior correspondent John Miller speaking there after the press conference from officials there from the greater Boston area. We apologize for some of the audio issues we were having at the outset of that press conference. We want to bring you the remarks of Governor Deval Patrick at the beginning.
Welcome to Drive Time. This is the Drive Time. Listening, the manhunt is still ongoing for the bomber suspect, so it's kind of crazy out there. Let's listen in.
I know you have many. First of all, we all want to thank the members of the public who have respected our request to stay indoors. We know what an inconvenience it is in Watertown and in Cambridge in particular, but really throughout the areas that we've asked for this. It's been enormously important and helpful to the many, many law enforcement who are trying to do their job. And we thank all of you for helping to get that message out. The stay indoor request continues for the time being.
Okay, yeah, so there's a lot going on out there. I've been looking at the internet all day, so it's kind of hard to pull away from. But you gotta, I guess, do that. Maybe they don't find him for. It seems like they had him. I mean, I don't know how long. Like, where the hell could he be? You know, it's kind of scary. But this is, you know, I'm trying to balance between the psychotic, like, need to know, which is, I mean, in this case, it's normal. There's, like, you know, it could be any town in America, and yeah, we don't have to deal with this shit every day. I get all that, its own thing. I want to talk about the book. I'm doing a project with books, I think. Here's a random one I pulled out. You see it? You see that? This is The Dark Child, a book called The Dark Child. I want to do a project where I have a bunch of books I wanted to get rid of, and they're not worth anything, so I wasn't really going to be able to sell them. So I want to leave them places, but I want to leave them places with, like, a note inside or some sort of paper inside. Make this kind of interactive game. Maybe set up a website where if you find this book and you read it and can answer a couple of series of questions on the spot, you get a prize from me. Or something, I don't know. Like, but maybe have a URL, be like, if you find this book, go to this website. And just kind of connecting people on a weird level like this with books and the public. And I think it'd be a good way, because I'm at the point now where they're not worth anything. I have about 50 to 100 books, somewhere in there. It's hard to tell. They're in a plastic thing in the back of my car. And, hold here. Away from the sky in Drive Time HD. So I got that book. I got these books. And I'm gonna, like, you know, I'll probably make a website saying, like, did you find the book? And then people find the book, like, what book did you find? Maybe have, like, a fill out form thing where they can be like, you know, or, like, maybe ask them to take a picture of themselves with the book and email it to a certain address. That's what the website will say. Or maybe I'll just write. Maybe I'll just create, the easiest thing to do would be just to create an email address and then write the email address in the book. Like, if you found this book, maybe just email a picture of yourself with the book. And then, I guess I'd have to sort of explain what I'm doing with it. I wouldn't want to just randomly take pictures of people and use them and not them know. You know, maybe I'll, whatever I do with it, I have to word it properly. so people know what they're getting into. My head is like, I have this weird head peeling thing that I'm going on my line, my forehead, where I itch it to death and I pick it at it and it's like scabs over. So that's a cool normal thing about me. Luckily I have hair and it's not noticeable because I have, you know, enough hair where it just kind of my bangs sort of hang over it. Not that I have like bangs, but I guess I have bangs. I have just a normal haircut. It's not even a long haircut, but there's just enough hair to go over the top. It's like right at the line of where my hair line starts. It's all red and dry, and I pick at it incessantly. Mr. Me, perfect me! Let's listen in.
Marathon bombing. 19-year-old Jokhard Tsarnaev. Authorities say the area being searched is narrowing, and they are now pursuing new leads. A controlled explosion also is planned for this afternoon at a home in Cambridge. Meanwhile, the other suspect in the bombing, Tsarnaev's brother, is dead, killed by police overnight. Get a quick check of sports. Again, 12:46, Gordon Damer.
Well, guys, as far as the sports schedule of Boston, everything pretty much on hold right now. Red Sox CEO, Sam Kennedy, saying they are waiting to hear from the about whether or not the Sox and the Royals game will go off at Fenway tonight. Bruins, they were scheduled to face the Penguins tonight. No word if that game's going to be canceled, but both teams did call off their morning skate today. As for locally tonight, Mets, they're back at home.
Oh, well, that's interesting. Okay, well, that's it. That's the show. B, episode B, 29B. All right.